Divorce Survival Rule Number 3, Your Friends. My name is Dr. Amy Botwinick with WomenMovingOn.com, and this is for Divorce360.com. This is one of the most difficult things that you have to deal with besides, well, it's one of the many difficult things that can come up with divorce is your friends or people that you thought were your friends. You really find out when you go through a divorce. But just to not be hard on some people, it is hard for them to know what to do. They were friends with both of you. Which side do they go on? Why do they even have to go on a side? Why can't they be neutral parties? Well, I think a lot of it is just human nature. First off, you know, you're going to hear, all your friends are going to hear different stories. They're going to hear it from your perspective or your spouse's perspective. Obviously, you know, depending on whom they hear from and who they believe, they're going to sway to that side. If you have some really true friends that are going to do the best they can to remain neutral, you know, it's a hard line for them to toe. So you want to keep those friends. You need to really kind of keep that arena neutral, not to complain or bash or just, it's kind of like walking on a tight wire rope. You want them to be there for your friend. They want to be there, but you have to be careful how much you dump on them because they just may run and hide because it's too much. And couples also get scared when their friends get divorced because it's like, if it happened to you, why, what am I invincible for? It could happen to us. It's almost like they feel like you have a leprosy. So some of your friends may completely drop out altogether. If the friends do try to do their best over time, typically what happens is they will gravitate towards either you or your soon-to-be ex. It's just human nature. So don't take it personal because it really has nothing to do with you. Typically, it's like the golden rule. Well, we were friends with him before we were friends with her, so we're going over on his side. I don't know. It's like very arbitrary sometimes how it happens or whatever their gut feels. It can get ugly and not so nice, very isolating, so prepare yourself for that. But again, don't take it personally. It's not about you. It's about their stuff and their insecurities and their fear and phobia. So, you know, with that said, when one door closes and some of your friends may completely disappear, you have a whole new chapter in your life coming up where you get to choose the friends and the people you want to hang out with. I mean, think about it. When you were married, did you really like all those people? Or did you just kind of go and hang with that because your spouse was friends with them and you didn't want to, you know, make waves, so you just kind of went with it? Well, now it's all about you, and you get to find your own posse, so it's not so bad. Just be prepared for big upheaval and people acting kind of like buffoons at times because they really don't know what to do with themselves. They want to be there for you, but they just may not at a time when you're at your most vulnerable. Not fair, not easy, but it is what it is. So your true blue friends will stick by you. The rest will fall by the wayside, and it's not such a big loss. So just be prepared to weather the storm and move on. My name is Dr. Amy Botwinick. This is for WomenMovingOn.com, and this is also for Divorce360.com.